There you are, Elizabeth. Did you follow up on the scans I ordered for Mr. Danielson?
Yes, the lab said they would have them in tomorrow.
Well, what time?
You know, they didn't say.
And you didn't think to ask?
I'll call them again.
I'm having a little problem with your attitude, Elizabeth. Now, I know that you checked yourself into Shady Brook, but you were there barely a day, hardly long enough to resolve your issues.
I can assure you that my personal problems won't affect my job.
I certainly hope you mean that.
Dr. Quartermain, do you have a problem with me?
I know that Lucky has left town once again, and I know that must be difficult for you. I also know that you have a tendency to turn to my son in a crisis.
I have no
Jason is a married man, Elizabeth. You find someone else to rescue you.
Sorry, ladies. I just need to get to my locker. I realized I never asked if the guest privilege is extended to the showers. Spent the last 24 hours working with a patient who was scheduled to be transferred to Shady Brook. Turns out she was in no condition to be moved.
Oh, well, I was going to speak to you about your guest status, Dr. Keenan.
So, the showers really are off limits.
No, it seems that we have a psychiatrist on staff opening. And from the work you've done here and in Shady Brook, I think you'd be a nice fit.
What do you think, Nurse Weber?
If you don't want a long-term commitment, of course we could make it temporary with our mutual review.
I'd have to discuss it with my supervisors at Shady Brook.
Well, let me know by next week, okay? And Elizabeth, make sure that the lab has those scans for Mr. Danielson on my desk by 10 tomorrow.
I will.
Oh. Is Elizabeth working on this floor?
Well, I just saw her in the locker room a few minutes ago.
Great. Thank you.
Oh, I meant to ask you, did you ever get a chance to talk to Jason?
I know that Patrick did a full battery of tests, but the results aren't back yet.
Does Elizabeth know this by any chance?
I don't think so. Why?
Well, now that Lucky's gone, I know Jason feels obligated to her because of Jake. I just don't want to see him taken advantage of.
I can understand why it would be painful that you didn't know Jake was your grandson while he was still alive, but that was Jason's choice not to tell you, not Elizabeth. You can't blame her for that.
Well, I've seen her go after Jason once before that ended in disaster. I just don't want to see it happen again.
Well, I'm pretty sure Elizabeth will be focused on other things.
Well, I hope so.
Monica? Did you summon me about Daddy or the hospital board?
Neither. I just wanted us to meet someplace where Edward couldn't overhear.
Overhear what?
Overhear this. Jeez, Tracy. All those digs about Jason. And here you are, marrying into the mob for the second time.
Your assistant told me I could find you here. I want you to print a retraction in the evening edition.
We're a morning paper.
Then you're going to be a bankrupt paper when I get through suing you for libel.
Every word in that article is gospel. It came directly from your fiancé.
I don't have a fiancé.
You'd better check that with Anthony Zakara because he's convinced that you're going to marry him.
Anthony Zakara is clinically insane, which you would know if you had bothered to do research.
This will be your second marriage to an organized crime figure, right? How would you compare Anthony to your late husband, Gino Salido?
All right. How much to pull the edition?
You mean take it off every newsstand in the city? Do you have any idea how much revenue I'd lose?
I'll make it worth your while.
I'm not for sale.
You were when you were mayor.
I'm already planning a follow-up tomorrow. Actually, there's going to be two articles, one in the business section and the other in the society page. My reporters will be contacting your father to get a quote.
To keep my father out of this.
How does he feel about getting Anthony Zakara as a son-in-law?
My father has a heart condition. Do not do anything to upset him.
I imagine Edward would find you marrying a gangster to be far more upsetting than anything I could print in my paper.
I'm on my way into the office. Make sure the head of legal is waiting for me when I get there.
Watch where you're going.
My deepest apologies. You seem distressed. Is there anything I could do to be of service?
Yes, as a matter of fact. Can you hack into the Port Charles press and print a retraction on the front page of tomorrow's edition?
Alas, I no longer possess the cyber skills needed for such a task.
Then you're wasting my time.